Welcome to Space to Ground, I'm Isidro Reyna. This week, launch updates to the station and more. A Japanese cargo spacecraft scheduled for launch to the International Space Station has been postponed. The initial launch of the JAXA H-2 transfer vehicle was scrubbed on September 10th due to a fire on or near the JAXA launch pad. See the latest updates on the launch status at nasa.gov. The next crew to launch to the station is at the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan for final mission training. Expedition 61 crew members Jessica Mir of NASA and Oleg Skripochka of Roscosmos will blast off on September 25th aboard the Soyuz MS-15 spacecraft with spaceflight participant Haza Ali Al-Mansouri. The trio from the US, Russia, and the United Arab Emirates will take a four-orbit, near-six-hour ride in space before docking to the station. Al-Mansouri will return to Earth on October 3rd aboard the Soyuz MS-12 spacecraft with NASA astronaut Nick Hague and Soyuz commander Alexei Ovchinin of Roscosmos. Mir and Skripochka will orbit Earth until the spring of 2020. As NASA prepares to send the first woman and next man to the moon, Brad Pitt is playing an astronaut in his latest film. The actor called up to the station to discuss what it's truly like to live and work in space with NASA astronaut Nick Hague, who is currently working aboard the orbiting laboratory.
I had read astronauts speak about looking back on the Earth and really being aware how insignificant we are in the grand scheme of things. Did you have a similar experience or something different?
You know, that's one of the special things about being up here is being able to float over to the window and see the Earth below. And you can see humanity below you, and you can see it glide by as we go screaming through the sky. And that perspective really challenges you, because now you're looking down at everything that you've ever known, all of humanity right there, and you have this deep appreciation for how big the universe really is.
Boeing, NASA, and the U.S. Army conducted exercises for the upcoming CST-100 Starliner missions. This series of mission dress rehearsals at the White Sands Missile Range in New Mexico focus on the landing and recovery aspects of Boeing's Starliner missions. This was one of three formal dress rehearsals that took place over the last couple of weeks as part of NASA's Commercial Crew program. Unlike any American-made orbital crew capsule, Boeing's Starliner is designed to land on land and is expected to touch down at one of five potential landing zones in the western United States, including two at White Sands. Astronauts Mike Fink and Nicole Mann of NASA and Chris Ferguson of Boeing observed a few of the exercises to better understand what will be happening outside Starliner before ground teams can open the hatch and officially welcome them back to Earth. Keep sending in your questions using the hashtag AskNASA. We'll see you next week.
Subscribe for more space.